Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. Today we're going to talk about the 8786D-I or 8786D-1 2-in-1 soldering and hot air rework station from Yihua. A soldering iron is self-explanatory, but what the heck is a hot air rework station? To put it simply, it's also soldering, but instead of using a hot soldering tip, it uses hot air to solder multiple legs or leads at the same time. It is more commonly used on surface mount devices or SMD to mount components directly onto the surface of a PCB. This is going to be quite a significant upgrade to my 60 watts adjustable soldering iron, the 9473, which is also from Yihua that I've been using ever since I created my channel almost 6 years ago.
Am I really that old now?
I've decided to get one because I have a few project ideas where I would need one. So, this is not a review or anything like that though. This is just an unboxing and some basic tests. Because this is the first time I'm going to use a hot air rework station. I don't have enough knowledge about it, so it would be disingenuous if I did a review. Let's go! So here's the box. It says thermostatic soldering station and hot air rework station. It's ESD safe, which means that it's safe from electrostatic discharge. 8786DI or 8786D1 is also marked here, indicating that we do have the model 8786D1. Alright, let's see what's inside it. We're greeted by the operation instruction because it wants us to RTFM before using it. Here are the specs. It says here that this is great for soldering and desoldering applications on small components like SOIC or small outline integrated circuit, chip IC or integrated circuits, UFP or quad flat package, PLCC or plastic leaded chip carrier, BGA or ball grid array, and SMD or surface mount devices. Here's the control panel map. Here are the instructions for temperature calibration, another operations manual, important safeguards. Inside the box, we have the heat gun nozzles. It would be nice if the sizes are indicated on them, but oh well. Here are the compatible parts for the soldering iron and hot air rework station that I would just call the heat gun to make it short. This is good because by including something like this, we can buy third-party parts because the dimension or specs of the parts are listed here. Here are some more heat gun nozzles. We also have the soldering iron. This is model 907G. It also came with a pre-attached pointy tip. As you can see here, I've already used this before, and I don't really like this pointy tip. We also have the soldering iron holder with a sponge. This is the hot air rework thing that I call a heat gun. The model is R208A. Nothing fancy, really. This is the air intake. And it appears to be permanently connected to the control unit, so let's just take a look at it next. This is the control unit. As seen earlier on the control panel map, this is the air temperature switch that turns the heat gun's heater on or off. So if you use the hot mode, it would turn on the heat gun's heater and would therefore produce hot air. And if the cool mode is turned on, it would turn off the heat gun's heater and would just push out ambient air. These are the soldering iron's temperature controls, and these are for the heat gun. This one is the airflow control knob. Here are the LEDs that display both the heat gun and soldering iron's temperature settings. This is where we connect the soldering iron. According to a quick search, it seems to be a 6-pin DIN connector. These are the individual on and off switches for each device, and at the back of the control unit, we have the main power switch. This is the exhaust, and this is where the fuse is located. Right, let's do some tests. I've already plugged this one to a power source, and this is magnetic, eh? Well, not actually magnetic, but more on that later. That's nice. Let's power this on. There we go. Upon turning on the control unit, the LED displays would just blink like this if either the heat gun or soldering iron are turned off or in standby mode. Let's turn on the heat gun. It's already set to 350 degrees Celsius. Alright, let's lower it to about 100. Since this is magnetic, I assume that this also acts as a switch, so let's see. The heat gun switch is turned on. The LED is displaying blank, but if we lift this up, it should automatically turn on. See? As you can see on the PCB, we have this some sort of sensor that really looks like a weed switch that is connected to this PCB, which is connected to ground and handle. And on the heat gun's holder, we have two magnets on the left and the right side. Once the heat gun is turned on, if the temperature switch is on hot mode, it will turn on the heat gun's heater and would slowly turn up the heat until it reaches the desired temperature setting that is displayed here. And as mentioned earlier, this knob controls the volume or speed of air that the heat gun is outputting. Hear that? To test the air temperature switch, as we can see on the display, it's currently set to 100 degrees Celsius. But if we push this switch, the temperature would slowly go down until the display shows COL. And apart from the sound that came from the switch's button press, we also heard a click, which I believe to be the relay that powers on the heater for the heat gun. Now, after putting the heat gun back to its holster, it should turn off. Why is it not turning off? Oh! Now, to test the soldering iron, let's resolder the wires on this LED strip to make it work properly again. I took this from the back of my monitor because it's not lighting up anymore. I mentioned earlier that I don't like the soldering tip that came with the 907G soldering iron, since it's pointy and not that good at spreading heat fast. And since I have quite a few tips at my disposal, I'm just going to use one of those. However, now that I've thought of it, a pointy soldering tip would be good for soldering and desoldering small components. So, I do understand now why it was the one that was included. And just like on my 9473 soldering iron, the tip on this one is also easily changeable. Alright, let's plug this one into the control unit. There's a notch or key right here so it would not be connected wrongly. There's also a sort of lock that we can use to secure it in place. Let's set this to 350 degrees Celsius. There we go. As we can see on the LED display, the temperature is gradually going up. This is awesome, because on my previous soldering iron, I can indeed set the temperature on it. But I have to wait and feel it first to check and see if it's hot enough before using it to solder. Alrighty, I already soldered the wires, so this time let's just add some more solder to it to make it pretty. There we go. Just need to prepare the wires. Now it's time for some soldering. After soldering, let's see if it would work properly. And there we have it. It's fixed. To no one's surprise, this heat gun is also really good for shrink tubes. See that? Feeling underwhelmed by the previous heat gun test, let's do some tests using it again. But this time, to remove and reattach an IC to a PCB. This is from a broken wireless mouse, by the way. Okay, before we proceed, let's remove potentially vulnerable stuff such as this plastic thingy. I think it would be good to try removing and reattaching this TC4056A charging module because it's not too small and also not too big of an IC. Okay, let's just wait for this to come off. And there we go. Now let's attach it again. I know I'm not doing this properly because I haven't fully removed the solders and just reusing them, but
this is fine.
A bit crooked and some pins are probably not even connected, but I don't have the proper solder for hot air reworking yet, so that's okay, I think. In conclusion, it's an awesome addition to my growing list of tools and equipment. As a hobbyist, I may not always put it to use or may not always need it, but for me, this is one of those things that I'm always really glad to have whenever I need one. However, one of the potential problems that I can see having with this down the line is one of the components breaking, because it's a set. If one of them breaks, it would just take some space on your desk even if you can't use it. Then again, assuming that replacement parts and/or units are still available in the future, I think they'd be easy to replace anyway, especially the soldering iron because it's detachable. Taking all of that into consideration, I think it's a good entry-level set for beginners because of its price and availability. I mean, obviously, there are other cheaper alternatives, but I based my decision to get one from Yihua because my other soldering iron is also from Yihua. It's 6 years old already and it's still functioning properly, and judging by how fast things seem to break these days, that's really something. Thanks for watching and see you again next week. Maybe.